So, Matthew Heimbach, how would you characterize the way the police handled yesterday?
I think that everything that happened yesterday was what the police wanted to happen. When we marched in with the Traditionalist Worker Party, the League of the South, and our other allies, we asked the police where they wanted us to go, and they pointed through the crowd of anti-fascist protesters and said to go through them to get to where our permitted space was. And we tried to clarify with them, saying that we have a permit to be here, we don't want there to be any conflict, and these people are throwing already, with the first 30 seconds, are spraying mace, they're attacking our folks as we're just trying to get to the rally. Are you going to be able to respect our right to be able to go to our permitted rally? And they had no interest in doing that. They had a total stand down order. They did nothing when they were throwing urine bottles at us, when they were throwing frozen cans of Coke and water at us that could concuss people, when they deployed impromptu flamethrowers to try and burn our members. And they, of course, they were using sticks, and several of our members were actually cut with knives. So the police had a total stand down as we were simply trying to move to get to our rally. It's either incompetence or they wanted a fight to happen. They wanted us to be attacked, and when they saw that we were defending ourselves, then they called it an unlawful assembly and then pushed us out of the park where more of our members were attacked. And then, of course, we stood strong, defended ourselves, and marched straight through town. So we achieved our objectives, but the police either wanted that to happen or were woefully incompetent.
Someone died yesterday because of your rally. I mean, a rally you helped organize. Someone's dead from that. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that? Do you feel at all responsible?
Not at all. These people were yelling, kill, kill, kill all the Nazis. They were using any weapon they could to try and kill the men and women. They were marching with me. They were standing for General Lee. They were standing for our heritage and just bringing our nationalist movement together. There would have been no violence whatsoever yesterday if the police had simply done their job and given the leftist protesters their own space to protest, which is their right, and we had been allowed to hold our rally. The left are the ones that were attacking us, and what happened with that car accident is, we don't know all the details on that, but it's the sort of thing that when there were mobs of people, that the night before at the Torchlight rally, over a dozen cars
You're calling it an accident, but the police are saying they're charging it with a crime. They're charging the driver with a crime.
Well, it's a crazy situation where you've got mobs of leftists that have been busting out windows, have been slashing tires, have been attacking people in the streets. We don't exactly know what happened, but what I do know is if you're in the car, you're surrounded by people that are flat out chanting that they want to kill you, because their definition of a Nazi is anyone they politically disagree with. That is a terrifying situation to be in, especially by yourself.
So there were actual swastikas there, though, which is sort of helps meet the definition of Nazism.
There are a lot of different folks there from a lot of different organizations. There were constitutional conservatives, there were libertarians there, there were national socialists such as ourselves, there were Southern nationalists, there were Confederate heritage defenders. We were coming together to say that we are going to stand together for our heritage, but the left wanted to attack all of us. They want to kill anyone they disagree with. They believe in no platform for people they disagree with, and we use violence to get that. We saw the violence of the left yesterday, and we saw also our resolve to defend ourselves and to carry forward our message of defense of our faith, family, and folk.
Do you think that President Trump being in the White House has contributed to this atmosphere of edgy discourse, violence in the streets? Do you think that has anything to do with the tenor of what happened yesterday?
I think we're seeing really the breakdown of the center of America. I don't think there really is a political center anymore. And I think Donald Trump, it doesn't cause that, but he is showing that. Of course, his election was really the white working class coming together to say that we are tired of open borders, we're tired of globalization, we're tired of endless imperialist wars. But we see on the left them radicalizing. You've got groups like the John Brown Gun Club that are training people with firearms to kill Nazis, to kill fascists, to kill people they disagree with. We see the burning down of cities, we see the attacks on police officers. The radical left is getting more and more violent every single day. You notice what we brought to that event were helmets. We brought shields to defend ourselves against the leftist attacks. The radical left is getting more violent every single day. We will defend ourselves, but we want peace. We simply want to be able to put our message out there. We're also not going to be cowed. We're also not going to back down when they threaten us. We will defend ourselves.
You must have known if you did a rally in a city like this that something like this might happen. You must have had some knowledge of that, that people would show up to say, we don't want you in our city, and violence would ensue.
These aren't locals. The majority, they had leftist, anti-fascist crews coming all the way from Seattle, from Portland, from Chicago, from New York, from Philadelphia, Baltimore, Atlanta. They were bussed in from around the country. The radical leftists understood if the nationalist community can come together, stand together, and fight together, that we are going to be unstoppable, that our rise, you know, just even going back since I've been involved in this movement, it used to be a rally of 50 guys was very successful. Now we're rallying 1,000, 1,500 people in the streets. Our movement is growing, and they are trying to use violence and intimidation to silence us, to try and stop our movement. They're not going to be able to do that. This was not a local, homegrown protest movement. This was the radical left that has a long history of terrorism and violence and intimidation trying to stop us, and they weren't able to do that.
Do you regret that someone was killed by what the police are saying is a murder by car?
The people wanted to kill us. They chanted that they wanted to kill us. I think it's regretful when any person loses their life, but I'm also not going to cry over someone that was trying to kill me and my comrades just a few hours earlier, ending up in that situation. This is the breakdown of the center of American politics and of public discourse, and these radical leftists truly are trying to kill anyone they disagree with. And we saw that with our actions yesterday. We saw that with the violence they brought, the improvised weapons they brought. So these people are not polite, friendly people that are trying to get their opinion out there. These are not protesters. These are leftist thugs. This is just going back to Weimar Germany, where the radical left are the ones that were attacking nationalist meetings, and the nationalists had to be able to defend themselves.
So what's next?
What's next for us is we're actually going to be focusing over the next several months, focusing on the opioid epidemic, because rural white working class America has been hit tremendously hard when it comes to the pharmaceutical industry and our government allowing drugs, both legal and illegal, to flood our communities, costing almost 50,000 deaths a year, majority white working class families. We are focused not on identifying ourselves as being against the left, but for our families, for our communities. And that's why we're going to be focusing on trying to help families, to bring awareness to this silent genocide that's being brought against white America, and continue to stand and be the voice of white America.